Well, Gary, I have to say, I'm quite pleased with our efforts in the office today. We've created what's possibly the world's shortest power pole for offices with really low ceiling heights using this system by Atkore. It's the Marco power poles. Now, it is actually the first challenge when something like this turns up is actually, how do you cut it? That's what we think about. And if you look at the extrusion behind us, this is enormous. And that was our first task. But where would we be using this really, Gary?
Yeah, so I went online, started searching some photographs of other examples of power poles, and I managed to find one that had like a Hoover attachment that came into a plastic pole to bring down data and power into the office, and it looked awful.
Yeah, and you do see a lot of efforts that people make to try and keep the office environment clutter-free, but we think this system here by Marco is a great system. We're going to have a look at it in a while. But yeah, those open plan offices, isn't it? That's the main thing that people think about when it comes to power poles. But here's a little bit of inside tip here, Gary. I've actually used these in factory environments in the past.
Right, okay. In what form?
Well, if you think of factories, particularly ones possibly some electronics or clean room conditions where you want to create, bring lots of services down to a machine or something like that. So I've used these with obviously power, data, but then some of the other things that machines use, compressed air and some rare gases.
Oh, right. So when you say clean air, you mean removing all those trip hazards that could be on the floor with those hoses?
Yeah, or sometimes people make their own efforts with obviously basket and cable trays and things like that. But I think actually a power pole in those scenarios can actually be a great solution.
Let's see the skills in order to make our miniature version of the power pole, which is identical to the skills you require. You're not backing yourself with a cut then, you've got the set square and pencil out.
Well, it's an aluminium profile, so it is pretty robust. It's certainly a lot more robust than some of the PVC-based extrusions that you see used for power poles. So I want to try and do as best job I can, so I'm going to use the Milwaukee.
All right, so a full length would be 3.6 metres. You can get a 1 metre extension, can you? And they will do special projects where they'll do a 5 metre length, is that right?
Yeah, so Atkore pretty flexible on this. So imagine you had a project where if very high ceilings or you had you required the same length and you didn't want to cut on site. This is the satin aluminium finish, so that sort of grey finish with the contrasting white PVC lid. You can also get it in powder coated white as well if you wanted everything to be white.
So it went nice and easy through the first section. Obviously there's a lot more material in the centre section. Once we're through that, we'll go quick again, won't it?
Yeah, so it's a double-sided extrusion, the same on both sides, but you're right, there's quite a bit of weight in the middle where the structural elements are.
Okay, I'd like to apologise now. I didn't quite catch it, did I?
Again, if you can't cut the edge straight, you have got some wiggle room in terms of this floor boot that's obviously fixed to the floor, clues in the name. Obviously overlaps the cut edge as well. I'd probably advise putting the smooth edge at the bottom that comes with the extrusion. And then if your edge is a little bit raggy, putting it on the ceiling one, because we'll see another accessory coming soon.
So this bracket here is going to allow us to jack up and jack down to go, say, towards that concrete ceiling to make that fixing. Is that what's happening by winding the bolt up and down?
Yeah, so this goes in between, say, where you'd have a suspended ceiling and a concrete slab. And then again, you can just create that so it's jacked between the floor and the ceiling. Then when you're done, you just lock off with this screw that we've got here into that structural element.
So the ceiling shroud comes in now, so we've come through a suspended ceiling tile and this will cover that area up, won't it?
Yeah, so you can clip this on before or after you put the lids on, obviously best when you finish the wiring, and that again hides the possibly you can't cut your ceiling tile as neat as it should be.
And we tried to show that with a bit of OSB in this shot here, haven't we?
Yeah.
So we're in with the boxes now. What standard depth do they come in?
25 and 35 millimeter boxes to allow for obviously different types of wiring accessory. Again, just quite plenty of knockouts on there. And they also is the option to buy a pre-made 50mm spacer if you can't cut your lid straight.
Or you're trying to get that exact distance between each of your accessories. I like the idea behind that. Clipping ever so satisfying when they do clip in and we get it under the lid. Is there any colours that we can have the lid in other than white?
Yes, so if you can, if you're working on a project that requires disability discrimination directive compliance or DDA, you can get a charcoal lid so you have a contrast with the sockets.
So we're inserting dividers now so we can segregate the band 1 and band 2. We're going to put Cat 5 cable in band 1. We're going to segregate it from band 2, which are 230 volts for our socket. You could have three compartments in there. We've only got two, haven't we, Gordon?
Yeah, so again, there's the mirrored side as well. You could put an additional divider in. Again, lots of options. Interestingly, it is the same lid and the same back boxes that we saw on the bench trunking that we looked at in a previous video. If you haven't seen that, I will leave a link in the description. So again, if you're using Atkore across a project, it'll match, but you can also interchange the components if you're working, upgrading or changing installation in the future.
Yeah, it's really clever. So it's just a case now putting the lid in again, it will slide just under so we can fit it nicely into position. And there's something again quite satisfying about clipping it down and having it held in place.
Yeah, the aluminium is incredibly robust. It's very easy to assemble this system.
So one more section on the bottom, and this shows you the, obviously as we go into the floor boot there, that we can slide it up and down as well, can't we? So we clip it into position, you got a little bit of play on that one as well. So maybe you could have cut it a little bit better than that, Gordon, but that's not a bad effort. You seem to be getting a dab hand with that Milwaukee. You alluded to in the video as well that it was two-sided, didn't we? So shall we spin it round so we can see that?
Yeah, so there's the finished side and there's the unfinished side. Obviously, so only your cables in for that first fix part of the installation. And this is incredibly solid, as I say. We can't stress that enough. You do see versions of this that are just made out of UPVC. That can obviously twist and things like that. This isn't going anywhere once it's jacked in against the ceiling.
It isn't. But as always, we're interested in your feedback. Are you currently working in offices? Are you currently working with power poles? You got any top tips for the community? Can you leave those in the comments below? Have you been working with this Marco power pole from Atkore and you want to leave some feedback about that as well? And we'll try and get back to as many as we can.